हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल बी डिस्कस अबाउट प्रोसेस ऑफ राइटिंग। ओके, राइटिंग की क्या प्रक्रिया है। फेयर एंड लेजिबल हैंड राइटिंग्स मेक्स अ मैन परफेक्ट इन ऑल वॉक्स ऑफ लाइफ, सेड महात्मा गांधी। टू कोटेशन, वेकन रीडिंग मेक अ फुल मैन एंड राइटिंग एन एग्जैक्ट मैन। According to Well, writing is a tool used to enable us to express what is in our mind and for some people is almost as important as speech. In schools, writing has its own instrumental value in school, a means for preserving the knowledge which the students gain or the judgment he has formed. It serves as a check on his forgetting useful items of knowledge and ideas. Some students have the habit of making notes of what they read and then summarizing it. This helps in the recollection of what has been studied. The learning of writing is one of the four linguistic objectives to teach a language. Okay. Teaching of writing. According to Well, writing is difficult art. It requires complete control of the muscles of the hand and wrist, and small child does not naturally possess this control. Okay, writing of English requires separate attention by the teacher. It involves the following. First, I teach to develop the skill of controlling the small muscles of the fingers and wrist. Next, teach the coordination of hand and eye. Third, make the students do several exercises in little work. Okay, our stages of teaching writing. English writing has four stages, namely, stage first, and this is a very important stage and it is related to motivation. This students need to be motivated to learn writings. Okay, the role of teacher is very vital at this stage. The students should be motivated using various motivational techniques so that the interest of the student is developed. Okay, abhyas stage second. This stage is related to penmanship, giving knowledge of writing letters of the alphabet. There are four methods of teaching penmanship, namely, first a kindergarten method, tracing method, free imitation method, F.G. Franz method. These methods will be discussed later in the chapter. Ab hai hamara stage third. Writing words and sentences should be taught at this stage. Along with this, emphasis should be laid on beautiful and uniform handwriting. For obtaining good handwriting, the following exercise should be done. Okay, next is calligraphy. Stage third में आती है calligraphy. A model word or sentence is written on the first line of the writing workbook. The students need to copy the same word or sentence many times under the model word or sentence. Okay. Further copying. The students are asked to copy the word or sentences from the blackboard or the book. The teacher is expected to supervise the students when they practice handwriting. This exercise has been advantage. Okay? इसमें ए है, इट इज़ वेरी हेल्पफुल टू रेनफोर्स द न्यू स्ट्रक्चर. नेक्स्ट बी, हेल्पफुल टू फिक्स द करेक्ट स्पेलिंग ऑफ वर्ड्स. Next, help the pupil to learn the conversation of writing capital letters and punctuations. Okay, next, dictation. The Indian school system has two objectives of dictation, to educate and to examine. According to West, the aim of dictation is to produce in the class a 100% accurate passage of writing, also to instill into their minds the correct spellings and pronunciation do really matter, and the nothing less than absolute accuracy is good enough. In fact, to produce a spelling कॉन्शियस क्लास ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स. ओके, नेक्स्ट है स्टेज फोर्थ. एट दिस स्टेज स्टूडेंट्स द इंटीग्रेट टू कॉम्पिटिशन राइटिंग विदाउट एनी हेल्प. फॉलोइंग ग्रेडेड एक्सरसाइज शुड बी डन. फर्स्ट है कंस्ट्रक्शंस ऑफ सिंगल सेंटेंसेज एंड राइटिंग दैम. नेक्स्ट कंस्ट्रक्शंस ऑफ सेंटेंसेज इन अ सिक्वेंस एंड राइटिंग दैम. नेक्स्ट बिल्डिंग ऑफ शॉर्ट पैराग्राफ्स एंड राइटिंग दैम. नेक्स्ट राइटिंग मोर देन वन पैराग्राफ, राइटिंग लेटर्स, राइटिंग स्टोरीज, राइटिंग फ्री कंपोजिशंस, राइटिंग कंपोजिशंस विदाउट एनी रेस्ट्रिक्शंस. ओके, अब पढ़ेंगे हम इसकी मेथड्स, इसकी क्या क्या विधियाँ हैं. फोर विधियाँ हैं. फर्स्ट है किंडरगार्टन मेथड. दिस इज बेस्ड ऑन द प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ किंडरगार्टन मेथड ऑफ एजुकेशन. इन दिस मेथड इज अ किंडरगार्टन बॉक्स इज यूज. इन दिस देयर आर पीसेज ऑफ वुड और प्लास्टिक और डिफरेंट शेप्स. By joining these pieces, the letters of English alphabet, both capital and small, can be formed. The students are made to practice constructing letters of the alphabet by joining the pieces. This method is based on the following merits. First, based on play method, interesting, easy, suit the nature of the small children. Certain demerits are tagged with this method. In India, the teaching of English usually starts from class 6, who belong to 10 to 13 years of age. This method is not appropriate for such big children. Okay, students who know how to write their mother tongue may not take interest in this method of learning. Next, the tracing method. Okay, this tracing method requires the learner to make movements over the printed or written letters with a pen or pencil. These letters are written on the dotted lines or in a frame. The teacher writes the letters with dotted lines on the notebook of students and asks them to move their fingers over the letters. So various exercise books are available for the children to practice. Okay, iski merits hain. This method is based on the principles of learning by imitation and the children are very comfortable learning by this method. Next is no scope of wrong learnings. Next, Dr. Montessori also recommended the method. Students are asked to move their fingers over sandpaper letters. The demerits of this methods are, first, the students entirely depend upon learning by imitation. It hinders the development of the ability of free writing. Okay, next, discourages the habit of hard work. It does not handle the individual differences properly. All the students reach up to same level of development. Next, free imitation method. The students copy down the model letters in their notebook written by the teacher on the blackboard or the notebook or written in books. Famous scholar Wells suggests that the model letters can be written on flashcard. Since the students imitate or copy the model letters with the help of their own imagination and retention power, so it is called free imitation method. This method has the following merits. Students get an opportunity to show their ability and skill. Students become self-dependent. Okay? Individual difficulties can be traced and removed with ease. Iski demerits hain. There are chances of mistakes in imitation. Due to mistakes, the development is slow. If the child copies a word incorrectly, he may retain the wrong information for life. It is tedious for the teachers as they need to put in hard labor in this method. Okay. Next, FG French method. FG French method hai ye. FG French has suggested that the beginner should not retard the art of writing straight away. They should be first instructed to do some handsome movements either with their fingers in a tray of sand or with by using chalk in a brown paper. Once the hand movement practice is over, the following procedure should be followed. First, teaching strokes, teaching circle, teaching combination of strokes and circles. टीचिंग कर्व्स, टीचिंग्स ऑफ कंबाइनिंग स्ट्रोक्स एंड कर्व्स. दिस मेथड हैज ऑल द मेरिट्स एंड डिमेरिट्स ऑफ फ्री इमिटेशन मेथड्स. बिकॉज इवन इन दिस मेथड ऑफ द लर्नर इमिटेट्स द टीचर. ओके, करेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ गुड हैंड राइटिंग. इसकी गुड हैंड राइटिंग की क्या विशेषताएँ हैं? फर्स्ट, द हैंड राइटिंग शुड बी लेजिबल. पुअर हैंड राइटिंग इज अ साइन ऑफ एन अनटाइडी एंड कन्फ्यूज माइंड. द गुड हैंड राइटिंग शुड बी सपोर्टेड विद गुड स्पीड. वट द टीचर शुड गिव प्रायोरिटी टू लेजिबिलिटी एंड देन स्पीड. इवन इफ रिटन विद स्पीड एट शुड बी इजी टू रीड. A good handwriting is a mark with uniformity of the letters. This does not mean that all the letters should be made of equal height, but one type should have equal height. All the ascending letters should have equal height and the descending letters too should go down. The handwriting should be attractive along with uniformity in size and shape. The letters should be suitably spaced and the written lines should be parallel to the top of the paper. Next, a good handwriting is also characterized by its style that includes size, spacing, alignment and the direction of strokes. Okay, thank you for watching.